Do you need to clear music rights for your social media advertising campaigns? Hi, I'm Gordon Firemark, and this is Asked and Answered, where I answer your entertainment law questions to help you take your career and business to the next level. Andrew wrote in with this question. I work at a production company, and we're looking into paid advertisement that tries to get the viewer to come to our website to contact us about work, and we'll be running those on Facebook and Google platforms. Now, we're not really sure how to navigate through the music licensing channels and wanted to ask, in terms of agreements for paid ads, specifically through Facebook and other social media platforms, not TV and radio, that are only to get your name out there to help to get clientele to do the things that you want. Do you need the full rights to a song? And if not, what do we need if it's only for social media platforms like Facebook and Instagram? What exactly are the parameters when it comes to being at risk of legal action if we use a song for our company's work reel, demo reel? Well, I'm afraid you will need to get proper music licenses for the songs and recordings that you use in all of your demo materials. Using someone else's copyright-protected material, like a song or a recording, is copyright infringement, plain and simple. Getting exposure for your business is a commercial use, and that's exactly the kind of thing that draws lawsuits. The risk of getting sued is high, and the liability, if you do get sued, can easily climb into the hundreds of thousands of, or even millions of dollars. But even if you aren't sued, you could spend all that time, money, and energy putting together your ads and then find yourself on the receiving end of DMCA takedown notices from the copyright owners or just cease and desist letters. So even if you're only doing a few Facebook or Instagram ads, you want to do these things right by getting a license for the music you use. Now, the process isn't difficult, but it is somewhat complex and mostly just time-consuming. First of all, remember that with recorded music, there are two copyrights that you have to think about. First, there's the song itself. That's what the composer and the lyricist, the songwriters, created. And it's probably owned or controlled by a music publishing company. And second, there's the so-called master recording, what the recording artist, producer, and engineers created. And that is likely to be controlled by the record label. So you need to track down the owner of each musical composition and each recording and ask for the specific permission or license that you need for the song. You're going to want a sync license for the composition and a master use license for the recording. Now, you'll probably be asked to submit the request in writing or by email or on an online form, and you'll need to be specific about exactly how much in terms of how many seconds and which part of the song is being used and what the context is and the nature of the visuals that it'll be attached with. And then the owners will eventually give you a quote, and if you agree to their proposed pricing, they will issue a license. And you'll have to do this for each piece of music that you use. So that's why many folks use music from production music libraries, where they can purchase one-time buyout licenses at relatively nominal fees for tracks that you can use in demos and temp editing and so on. Or you could hire a composer to write music specifically for your projects. But be sure if you do that, that you get the deal in writing and that the terms are crystal clear about ownership and payment. All right, that's it for this session. I'm Gordon Firemark, and if you have a question you'd like to see here on Asked and Answered, just head on over to firemark.com/questions and let me know. See you next time.